Saya nggak ngerti maksudnya apa. Pertanyaannya, apakah dia dapat dihubungi gitu?
Pak Lukman yang Bupati Majene tempo hari yang Bapak sempat itu sudah ya. Diganti.
Oh, sudah diganti. Oke. Sudah diganti ya. Baik, izin saya menyapa semua kembali. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Sawadikap, very good morning to everyone. Achan, Dennis, Mr. Presence, Bapak Rektor Universitas Sulawesi Barat, dan juga Achan Jupon. Saya melihat juga di sini sudah hadir rekan-rekan dari partisipan dari kegiatan ini. Kita berusaha untuk memulai lebih pagi karena di sini sangat pagi sekali hari ini, Bapak-bapak, Ibu-ibu, sehingga kita menyesuaikan dengan Sulawesi Barat saat ini sudah pukul 9. Saya kira ada teknikal tadi sekitar 10 menit. Saya pikir ini satu acara kegiatan yang sudah baik sekali yang kita rencanakan pada hari ini. Di Konsulat Indonesia Songkla pada pagi hari ini cukup cerah, Bapak Rektor, Bapak-bapak, Ibu yang lain yang hadir di sini, yang bisa saya sapa, dan kita akan membuat kegiatan ini sebagaimana kita rencanakan pada minggu lalu, antara difasilitasi oleh Konsulat Indonesia Songkla, nama saya Fahri Sulaiman, saya konsul RI di sini, konsul Indonesia di sini, dan ini adalah kegiatan bersama antara Konsulat Publik Indonesia di Songkla, Universitas Taksim, Universitas Sulawesi Barat, dan tentu komunitas UMKM di Sulawesi Barat, khususnya di Majene, dan juga Polem Bali Mandar, itu ya istilah Polmar, Pol, apa istilah yang kemarin pada sir ya, Polem Bali Mandar, ya, satu kabupaten yang berbatasan, dan itu posisinya adalah di border lah, kampus Universitas Sulawesi Barat ini pernah saya kunjungi beberapa waktu yang lalu. Bapak Rektor dan hadirin yang kami muliakan, di antara nanti pembicara-pembicara yang akan menyampaikan ini untuk memberikan pencerahan bagi kita bersama, ini saya akan jelaskan kembali Bapak Rektor bahwa rekan kita Dennis dari Taksim University dan juga networkingnya di Thailand Selatan dan juga di Thailand Utara, bahkan satu Achan Jupon ini dari Meiju University di Jupon sana, adalah para peneliti, para penggiat ya, kegiatan-kegiatan penggerak ekonomi dan untuk memajukan UMKM. Saya terus terang tertarik dengan apa yang dilakukan oleh rekan-rekan di sini, dan saya pikir kita bisa membawakan ke tanah air. Dan ternyata persahabatan, kontak-kontak yang dilakukan Pak Nasir Badu di Sulbar selama ini, Pak Rektor, dengan rekan-rekan di Taksim, dan pertemanan mereka cukup memudahkan bagi kita untuk berkoordinasi dalam waktu yang tidak terlalu lama. Bahkan birokrasinya pun ringkas sekali sesuai dengan normal sekarang, namun demikian bisa kita catat sebagai kegiatan kita bersama. Bapak Rektor, Achan Dennis, Achan Jumpon, Pak Nasir dan para research person di sini sudah hadir juga. Research person kita kemarin tidak, dan juga ada rekan kita seorang penerjemah, Dr. Abdul Hakim, yang akan memandu diskusi kita ini sehingga dapat diikuti oleh rekan-rekan kita dari UMKM di Indonesia, binaan Universitas Sulawesi Barat. Dan Abdul Hakim ini dia melanjutkan pendidikannya di IPB, yang untuk master degree-nya, dan doktornya pun dia selesaikan di Malaysia, kalau saya akan sampai. Nanti bisa beliau menjelaskan tentang jati dirinya. Beliau akan menjelaskan dalam bahasa Indonesia yang baik, insya Allah, masih terpelihara dengan baik bahasa Indonesia Abdul Hakim ini. sehingga memudahkan bagi teman-teman partisipan, apa namanya, rekan-rekan yang menjadi anggota dari diskusi kita UMKM kita hari ini. Kegiatan ini secara sederhana, Bapak Rektor, adalah kita mau sharing knowledge ya dengan kawan-kawan UMKM peserta Zoom meeting pada pagi hari ini untuk kita dapat mengemas, itu kira-kira ya sederhana, mengemas hasil karya anak bangsa di Sulawesi Barat khusus umumnya dan Kabupaten Kepulauan Maluku Mandarini dan Majene untuk kita dapat masuk kepada pasar internasional. Problem kita selama ini, Bapak-bapak, Ibu-ibu, adalah tidak link and match-nya antara produk kita dengan pasar. Nah, Dr. Dennis dan kawan-kawan ini, Dr. Citinda, juga Dr. Cumpon, akan membawa kita bagaimana pasar Thailand ini kalau Anda ingin promosikan barang-barang kita ke luar. Contoh sederhana saja, umpamanya saya aja orang Indonesia, Pak Rektor. Saya selama ini mengenal sarung Bugis. Saya pikir itu dari Makassar. Ternyata itu dibikin di Mandar. Sarung Bugis terbaik itu ada di Mandar ternyata. Tapi tentu tidak bisa kita tanya di Maros. Oh, sarung Bugis ada di Maros. Nah, tapi kita tidak akan diskusi siapa mengklaim apa. Tapi I was there, Bupati Majene, kebetulan saya kenal Pak Lukman ya yang lalu. Dan saya pernah berada di situ. Dan saya adalah warga kehormatan Mandar, ya, warga kehormatan Majene ya. Dengan saya disematkan pin sandek itu di Pak Lukman pada waktu saya berkunjung ke sana. Jadi please teman-teman, adik-adik, rekan-rekan saya penggerak UMKM di Sulawesi Barat, gunakanlah kesempatan ini sebaik-baiknya. Bapak Rektor dan Bapak Dennis dari Taksim, ya, Profesor Erick Senaksan, Jalaluddin dan Dr. Dennis ini, dan saya akan memfasilitasi, kami fasilitator saja. Ini adalah wujud dari Tridharma Perguruan Tinggi di kedua belah pihak dan juga persembahan saya untuk rekan-rekan di Sulawesi Barat untuk kita memulai sesuatu. Saya menyampaikan terima kasih itu pada Pak Nasir Badu yang telah menjadi pendukung selama ini dalam komunikasi kita dengan pihak Taksim. Nanti alur kegiatan akan dipandu oleh Pak Kim. Nanti ada kita mendapatkan sambutan Pak Rektor, perkenan kiranya Pak Rektor untuk atas nama kita juga menyapa kita semua. Dan Dr. Dennis juga akan membuka acara ini bersama-sama dengan kita. Kita adalah co-host Pak Rektor, Pak Dennis. Inginkan saya menyapa dalam bahasa Inggris. Very good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Dr. Dennis, Dr. Cetida, Dr. Abdul Hakim, Dr. Cumpon, Resort Person dan Dr. Nasir Abu Abadu, business guest, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Fahri Sulaiman, Konsul Jai, Republik Indonesia in Songkla. I've been here 3 years, and it is a great honor for me, and very happy knowing you guys, and you can work together with me, hand in hand. So you make my dream come true to give something to the province of West Sulawesi, especially Majene, Polewali Mandar, and to those I know in that area. I visit there once. I lost your visit more than 5 times, I believe, Dr. Dennis. Dr. Cumpon also visit Majene many times, more than 5 times. Dr. Nasir Badu, very nice man. Invite a friend to come to Sulawesi Barat and knowing the campus. I visit only once, Rector, to give a lecture in your campus in international relations when I visit Sulawesi Barat, Majene, around three years ago. I give a lecture there, sharing with a student of international relations. It's very nice. And it was a surprise, Dr. Dennis. Normally, university is located in the capital city of province, but in West Sulawesi, we can find the State University in Majene. It is a border of Mandar. It is very, very good initiative. And I was surprised also the this province also famous with the some of the PVIP and with the high rank level persons in my country also come there. I know a former chief of police commissioner also from that province or that region. And I do hope all of you can share with my fellows, give in very simple language, and I do hope Abdul Hakim can explain and can translate in a very short terms, give us enrichment and for this information. I thank you very much again. My deepest respect to the Taksin University, Major University, and my best regard to the president of this university. Thank you very much, and Pak Abdul Hakim, I give you floor
thank you, Pak.
Control the discussion. Thank you very much, Kapu Makam. Assalamualaikum.
Thank you. Terima kasih, Pak. Nanti Bapak ada sesi untuk give a speech sekali lagi, kan?
Okay.
Good morning, distinguished guys, ladies and gentlemen. And also here we have a student from Indonesia and from Taksin University in Thailand. Arun Suwatan Pumikiet Tutuk Tan Krapom. And selamat pagi peserta yang dihormati sekalian. And officially welcome you to Economic Diplomacy Webinar, a half day international symposium on the conceptualization of One Kampung, One Product, OKOP, in Majene, West Sulawesi, Indonesia. Perspective sharing between Indonesia and Thailand in collaboration with the Consulate of the Republic of Indonesia in Songkhla, Taksin University, Major University, and also Universitas Sulawesi Barat. First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Abdul Hakim Mandiyah. I'm originally from Pattani province in Thailand, and I am a lecturer in Economics Department of Taksin University. I would like to give thanks to Assistant Professor Dr. Tuan Tong, who invited me to join this program to be a Master of Ceremony, and also for Thai Indonesia translator. And also I would like to use this chance to say happy for 76th anniversary of the Independence Day of the Republic of Indonesia. Ucapkan selamat Hari Kemerdekaan Republik Indonesia tahun yang ke-76. Before we start, may I shortly introduce our speaker for today. We have six speakers from Thailand and Indonesia. Excellency Mr. Fajli Sulaiman, the Consul of the Republic of Indonesia in Songkhla. Excellency Dr. I.R.H. Ahsan Jalaluddin MS, Director of Universitas Sulawesi Barat. Excellency Dr. Muhammad Nasir Badu, Assistant to the President for Community Services, Universitas Sulawesi Barat. Excellency Assistant Professor Dr. Tuan Tong John, Assistant to the President for Academic Services and Community Affairs from Taksin University in Thailand. Excellency Assistant Professor Dr. Chumpon Angkananun from Major University, Chumpon Campus, and also Excellency Achan Chontida Ketpet, the Head of Fine and Applied Art Program in Design, Faculty of Fine and Applied Art from Taksin University in Thailand. Before we start the first session, I would give a time for each speaker to talk around not more than 20 minutes. Are you agree, sir? Okay, now may I have the honor to invite Mr. Fajli Sulaiman, the Consul of the Republic of Indonesia in Songkla to give a speech in detail of the program. Please welcome, dengan segala hormat, dipersilakan Bapak Fajri untuk pembukaan program ini. Please welcome.
Baik, terima kasih Pak Hakim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Again, I take the floor again for the following our rundown. I start already actually before just to say hello, and I again to convey my appreciation to the president of Tasik University, to the rector of Universitas Sulawesi Barat, now Dr. Saudara Hasan Jalaluddin has joined with us, and also the Achans, Dr. Tertida, Dr. Tumpor, and also, of course, our one of our scholars there, Abdul Hakim, dan tentunya my best friend Nasir Badu dari Universitas Sulawesi Barat. Rekan-rekan, ladies and gentlemen yang kami hormati, this, as I mentioned earlier, that this program is part of the our program in commemoration of the 76th of Independence Day of the Republic of Indonesia. During this month, recently this date, today is months ago, ladies and gentlemen, we celebrate 76th of Independence Day. So during this month also, any activity in Indonesia, we do it to celebrate our Independence Day. Now today, I learned together with Dr. Dennis, Dr. Nasir Badu, that what can we do for our colleague in our economic persons in Indonesia. And when you come with the idea to do a half-day webinar to share our knowledge, to empower our friends in Majene and also in Mandar, to give them the information how to compete in the open market during the pandemic COVID-19. I was informed by Dr. Nasir Badu that some of the economic community in that area are very eager to find new market in very restricted time in this time being. And we start with how to package our product, how to know the taste of the customer in Thailand. So based on that idea, Dr. Dennis and other persons, we agreed that you, all of you, can share with my fellows in Indonesia. And luckily, Universitas Sulawesi Barat, Bapak Rektor, also support our program, and also the President of Tasik University also support this program. And we see in the same perspective. And from that point, I think it is a very nice day. We in Indonesia say in Muslim, Jumat Barokah, Jumat Barokah, we are lucky Friday now. We have any resource person that we can share with us. Bapak Rektor, izin kembali kami sampaikan bahwa gagasan ini memang jadi gagasan original kita bersama selama ini. Universitas Sulawesi Barat tegak aktif menyampaikan pertukaran pelajarnya ke Thailand Selatan dan beberapa kali, bahkan 2 tahun yang lalu ya, baru kita juga bertemu dan merayakan 17 Agustus 3 tahun yang lalu. Dan saya melihat keinginan teman-teman dari Sulawesi Barat mendapatkan pengalaman internasional itu sangat baik. Unfortunately, Bapak Rektor, saat ini dengan pandemi COVID-19, kita tidak dapat hadir secara fisik. Demikian, Pak Rektor, dalam beberapa observasi kami, dalam 541 hari terakhir ini, masa pandemi ini berlaku, kerjasama-kerjasama antar universiti sangat memungkinkan kita kembangkan lagi, Pak. Saya baru saja dihubungi oleh kolega Bapak Rektor Universitas Andalas, yang berkata-kata, di negeri berbadan hukum, ya bisa sadarlah mereka juga sudah mulai untuk membangun networking di sini. Dan saya juga dapat laporkan ke Pak Rektor, saudara-saudara Bapak Rektor Universitas Pancasila di Jakarta juga telah melakukan hal yang sama, dan Universitas Negeri Semarang pun demikian, Pak. Jadi tidak tertutup kemungkinan melanjutkan apa yang sudah dirintis sebelumnya oleh Universitas Sulawesi Barat. Most welcome, Pak, teman-teman di sini, apalagi Universitas Sulawesi Barat sudah punya hubungan baik dengan Taksin University, dan hari ini kita juga kenal dengan Meiji University di Cumbon Kampus, itulah nama dosennya juga Dr. Cumbon. Ini juga menjadi upaya kita untuk menaikkan kelas universitas kita di Sulawesi Barat. Saya pernah berkunjung di sana, dan saya tahu perjuangan ini juga unik. Ya, Bapak sebagai scholars dan sebagai rektor persis membangun universitas di sebuah kabupaten berbeda dengan membangun universitas di sebuah provinsi. But I believe Bapak Rektor, semangat di Sulawesi Barat ini, instead pergi ke kota lain jauh-jauh, mereka bisa belajar di. Demikian singkat saja, Pak. Mudah-mudahan Bapak juga berkenan menyaksikan untuk acara ini. Sebenarnya restu Bapak selama ini kami sangat menghargai. Dengan mengucapkan bismillahirrahmanirrahim, saya tidak berpanjang lebar. Saya buka dengan resmi workshop setengah hari ekonomik webinar diplomasi ini. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Pak Fir, silakan.
Terima kasih. Thank you very much for Mr. Fajri Sulaiman, the Consul of the Republic of Indonesia in Songkhla, to give our speech for opening today. Now we are going to listen to the Dr. IRH Hasan Jalaluddin, Director of Universitas Sulawesi Barat, to talk about the policies and activities of Universitas Sulawesi Barat to contribute for a local product development. Dengan segala hormat, majelis dipersilakan Bapak Hasan Jalaluddin untuk memberikan materi. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih, Dr. Abdul Hakim Madijo. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Selamat pagi. Sawadika kepada kita semua. Yang mulia Mr. Fahri Sulaiman, Konsul Republik Indonesia untuk Songkhla. Selamat datang secara virtual Pak Dimajene. Ya. Jadi dan staff yang hadir di sini ada Mr. Riyadi dan yang lain tidak kelihatan. Mohon maaf. Jadi saya pernah datang ke Songkhla, ke konsulat jenderal di Songkhla, waktu itu wakilnya ibu ya, tahun 2016 gitu. Jadi saya diantar oleh Dr. Cumbon dari Universitas Utara Malaysia waktu itu lewat darat, Pak. Jadi saya sudah injak sampai ke tempat makan ikan yang enak di pinggir laut. Ya. Ini ada Dr. Cumbon di sini.
Ada.
Saya sudah menikmati suasana Songkhla. Ya, waktu itu mampir ke Universitas Songkhla. Ya, apa namanya ini Prince Songkhla University kalau tidak salah. Ya, ya jadi. Dan mungkin di bawah ini Bapak juga, saya juga sudah 2 tahun lalu sebelum COVID itu saya datang di Cumbon. Melalui, dan di Universitas Suratani. Jadi karena airportnya lebih dekat ke situ. Jadi waktu itu Pak Nasir ada di sana, Pak. Saya dilapori katanya pernah lebaran di Songkhla ya, waktu membawa mahasiswa kami kurang lebih 20 orang ya. Baik. Yang sama saya hormati juga ya Honorable Asisten Profesor Dr. Tuan Tong Krucon, ya. Kemudian Profesor Dr. Cumpon, ya. Tadi ada di screen, ya. Good morning, ya. Miss Cutida Ketpet, ya. Mohon maaf, ya. Sorry for pronunciation, ya. Maybe. Dan di pertemuan kita ini, Pak Konsul, ini juga hadir para kepala dinas dari Pulau Wali Mandar dan Majene, hadir kepala Bapeda Majene, kemudian kepala Balitbang Penyuluhan Pulau Wali Mandar, kemudian kepala dinas Perindustrian dan Perdagangan Kabupaten Majene, Kabupaten Pulau Wali Mandar juga, dan kepala dinas Pemberdayaan Masyarakat Desa Kabupaten Majene dan Kabupaten Pulau Wali Mandar. Ya. Ya. Dr. Abdul Hakim, jadi beberapa orang hadir ini kepala-kepala dinas, ya, tolong nanti disampaikan kepada audiens bahwa karena pentingnya acara ini, jadi beberapa board of government, ya, already is here to follow this webinar, economic webinar this morning. Ya. Dan seluruh hadirin yang saya muliakan, ladies and gentlemen, saya menyambut baik acara ini, Pak Konsul, ya, alhamdulillah dengan inisiasi Pak Konsul untuk melaksanakan webinar pada pagi hari ini. Begitu saya disampaikan oleh Pak Nasir, saya setuju, ya. Saya setuju dan insya Allah pada hari ini kita akan laksanakan pada pagi hari ini. Jadi tidak ada masalah dan ini adalah kegiatan yang sangat berguna baik untuk mahasiswa kami, untuk dosen-dosen kami dan juga perlu kami sampaikan sedikit bahwa kerjasama antara pemerintah Indonesia dan khususnya Universitas Sulawesi Barat dan pemerintah di Thailand Selatan, terutama Universitas Maijo Taksim, ya. Juga di Malaysia Utara seperti Universitas Sains Malaysia, Universitas Utara Malaysia, itu sudah lama kita bina dan program Pak Menteri Pendidikan dan Kebudayaan saat ini yaitu Merdeka Belajar. Alhamdulillah Universitas Sulawesi Barat sudah lama menyelenggarakan Merdeka Belajar itu dengan belajar ke luar negeri bahkan, ya, termasuk di Vietnam. Jadi Vietnam sampai ke Thailand Utara juga, kebetulan Maijo University ini ada juga di Chiang Mai dan juga ada di Chungpon. Jadi saya sendiri secara pribadi sudah datang ke kedua tempat ini dan menyaksikan kegiatan-kegiatan pembelajaran yang ada di sana. Jadi oleh sebab itu kami sangat antusias untuk bisa meningkatkan kerjasama itu. Sayangnya ini ada pandemi COVID-19 sehingga, tapi dalam kondisi sekarang ini Pak Konsul, saya sudah siap untuk kemanapun karena saya sudah booster. Saya sudah vaksin booster. Saya lihat kebijakan di Thailand itu sejak bulan Juli juga sudah booster. Jadi kepada masyarakatnya. Jadi saya sudah ready untuk kemana-mana pun ini. Tinggal saya diajak Pak Nasir Badu ini, Pak. Memang kami Universitas Barat ini selalu berhubungan dengan Konsulat Jenderal, termasuk di Turki, Pak. Jadi beberapa kerjasama yang kami lakukan di Turki itu dengan Konsulat Jenderal Istanbul ya dari waktu itu. Baik. Mungkin materinya bisa dikonekkan, Pak. Ya.
Izin share screen boleh? Pak Abdul Hakim, kami tak dapat access to be a co-host, so that's why we need
mohon
to,
izin,
to be
Pak.
A co-host.
Maksud saya menggunakan.
Gimana, Pak? Maaf.
Kami perlukan jadi co-host sebab kami tidak sharing kami PowerPoint.
Bisa sharing langsung. You can share from your laptop, I think.
Tak boleh. Right? Ya, Pak. Abdul Hakim tak boleh. Ini host disable participant.
Acan Tuan Tong ครับ ปกติ คือ สามารถ share ได้ไหมครับ เพราะว่า
เดี๋ยวทางกงสุลจะเปิด host ครับ ทางกงสุลจะเปิดให้ share ครับ
kita akan upayakan dari sini bukannya apa
ya, ya, ya.
Ya we try
oke okay.
Jadi berbicara masalah one kampung one product ini Pak Konsul sebenarnya ya. Kami sudah lakukan sudah lama juga di Indonesia khususnya di Provinsi Sulawesi Barat. Jadi kebetulan saya setelah lulus PhD tahun 97 yang lalu, saya langsung menjadi konsultan untuk community empowerment yang participative approach. Ya. Nah, mungkin ini bagian dari yang ingin kami sampaikan. Ya. The title of materi will be delivered is a implementation of the one kampung in Indonesia we call one village one product in Malaysia in Thailand we call OKOP and in Indonesia we call OPOP. Okay, next. Yeah, starting from the government policy, from the 1999 until 1998, Indonesia, the village development based on the policy of the central government. So, all the program from the central government. Yeah. And when the reformation, in Indonesia on 1998, we changed the policy. Yeah. Become autonomy, local autonomy, and the area for local autonomy in regency, not in province. Yeah, this is because of the political matter. Yeah, maybe if the local autonomy put in province, maybe it could be become something like federal country. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, we don't know. But until now, the head of province and head of regions sometime how to say. Masih saling tarik menarik kepentingan antara gubernur dan bupati because based on the law the undang-undang it say that autonomy in kabupaten but it should be autonomy in province. So sometimes the governor is the bupati in local local in region not obey the instruction of the government. So this is difficult to implement the governance method. And in the basic government is a village, in village. Now from the central province, local until village, the head of that the does the leader by election, even in the village now, by election. So the head of village by election. So sometimes political matter in regency and in province exists in village. I mean, maybe something like politic, money politic. Yeah. So this is why in the village leader now rather strong. Yeah, not tidak ikut campur, susah dikendalikan oleh bupati. Jadi ini yang terjadi dan this is implement until from the 1998 until now. So the ministry of the village in the central government recognize the village on 2016 by the pengadaan apa itu local participative local facilitator from the village mulai tahun 2016 and actually West Sulawesi province we have a program for a building for depth of village it's called Bangun Mandar and the now the new governor we have a program for village it's called Marasa. So this program how to build the village, the community to increase the economy aspect. Okay, next. Cooperation between West Sulawesi University and Ministry of Village Development of Disadvantaged Region and Migration. There are two programs. The first is recruitment of village supervisor and facilitator since 2016 and 2018. And the second, reset for effectivity of village budget spending. This is implemented on 2018 and 2019. So now, every village, the government, the central government, give money about 1 billion 1 billion until 1.5 billion. So this is this money enough for development the infrastructure and the social activity in the village. Okay, next. One village, one product program to increase the village income using the participatory rural appraisal approach. So we use this approach to manage this village in from the Universitas Sulawesi Barat to the community, we use rural appraisal participatory approach to identify the village potency and community and organization to find the regional advantage and to make a project design of one village, one product. And the result, next one. Now we have several village, for example, in Moso Dua village, we have one product, one village. It's called Sosis. Exomori, Sosis Exomori. This is sosis made from the flying peas. There are one village in called Moso Dua in West Sulawesi Pins in Majene Regency. Every time production flying fish, and this product sometimes overproduct, so that is why we try to make sauces this sauces fortification between how to say down calor, the I don't know, the down calor is mooring. Yes, mooring. This vegetables more vitamin A, yeah, and mineral. And we have to Sabang Subi pilot based on herbal and spices. This is for skin, for yeah, something like that. Yeah. And we also have a Binuang pilot based on marlin fish commodity. Yeah, I don't know the name. Yeah, but we call abon ikan marlin.
Ah, okay, abon.
Yeah. Yeah, abon. This is from the ikan marlin.
Yeah. Abon was in
it. Yeah. And next, then we also have pale meal commodity. In Indonesia, we call uh, bahasa Indonesia-nya apa kan? Bukan. Jewawut. Jewawut. Per, ya, per millet. We make a dodol. Dodol tariang. We call dodol tariang. Yeah. This is... and we have Desa Tamangale, ya, Tamangale Village based on seal, seal sarung. As Pak Konsulat, yeah. This is a sarung mandar. Yeah. This I wear the.
Oh, you closer. Ah, yeah, sir. Wah. Suai.
Ah.
Suai, Pak Rektor, suai.
Kami kirim, Pak Konsul.
Pak Denis, Pak Tontong tuh.
Kurayan ininya. Ya. Kalau Pak Cumpon sudah sering dikalungi, anu.
Oh, gitu ya.
Majene dikarungi sarung mandar Pak Dr. Cumpon. Kalau Pak yang dari Taksin pernah ke sini?
Pernah.
Pernah juga Dr. Tontong ya?
Pernah Tontong juga? Ya.
Oh, Dr. Saki hadir juga. Iya. Jadi beberapa teman-teman yang datang ya, itu kita oleh-oleh dengan sarung mandar ini Pak Konsul ya. Mudah-mudahan nanti Pak Konsul datang lagi, ini pandemi segera hilang, atau kalau semua sudah booster sudah bisa datang ke sini Pak
Konsul. Insyaallah.
Nah, yang terakhir kami next Pak. Kami punya juga desa ya. This Binua Binanga Village. Based on mangrove village tourism, and ini pernah didatangi oleh sejumlah 10 negara untuk program maritime yacht program. Jadi mereka menanam mangrove di area ini. Ya, kita ada kurang lebih 60 orang dari berbagai negara ya, termasuk dari Thailand yang datang ke sini untuk menanam mangrove. Jadi cukup banyak mahasiswa-mahasiswa yang lalu itu ada 6 orang dari Thailand Selatan ya, dari Cumpon, dari Maejo, dari Taksin ya, itu datang ke kita untuk belajar, dan kami ajarkan beberapa budaya-budaya yang berkembang di sini. Mungkin itu beberapa hal yang ingin saya sampaikan Pak Konsul dan seluruh hadirin. Mudah-mudahan ini bermanfaat ya. Demikian, wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima kasih. Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you very much for Dr. Ahsan Jalaluddin, Director of Universitas Sulawesi Barat, for give a talk. And describe about the program of university to the local product, to development product. Next, I would like to invite Dr. Muhammad Nasir Badu, assistant to the president for community services from Universitas Sulawesi Barat, to give a speech, give to talk about the perspective on product development in community through university participation. Dengan segala hormat, persilakan Bapak Nasir Badu.
Okay, thank you very much, moderator. Excellency, Bapak Konsul, Pak Fahri, Honorable Dr. Tuan Tun Kruchon, Honorable Dr. Chumpon, Honorable Pak Rektor Dr. Insinyur Aksan, and then all of the participants who present this morning. Thank you very much for opportunity. So in here, I would like to say hello to my colleague, Dr. Zaki from UUM, Dr. Senyawati and Dr. Harry from Hasanuddin University, Dr. Ayu Mandasari from Unsulba, Dr. Murlela, and then others, lecturers and then students. So let me continue to our program with my presentation. In here, I would like to present, and then I give the title is ABCD, Best Community Development. Of course, this is based on our own experience to help the community in Sulawesi Barat, particularly in my office, of course, is community service. Okay, next. What's that ABC? ABCD? ABCD actually is asset-based community development that we develop in our office and then to help the community in Sulawesi Barat. ABCD, of course, is one perspective. This perspective is to see the perspective from community problems that we have to know and two community assets. Of course, this is approach based on understanding and developing asset owned by the individuals or maybe the communities. Empowerment through community participation and then a combination of assets and opportunities. Of course, this is developed by our office for helping the people. I inspired by Dr. Dennis and Dr. Chumpon as well. A few times they visit us in here and give us enlightenment and then give us a lot of advices about what we have to do for develop our community. So that's why we receive that and then continue to help our community with this program. Anyway, Rector also support us, you know, to give our lecture funding to help the community. Was there to create a lot of programs for them. What the rationale of this is ABCD program, actually, nobody has nothing. That means everyone, of course, has capacity and gain capability. Everybody has something to contribute. The community has, everybody has something to contribute for what they increase they of the wealthy, of course, and then they was that to increase they what they call it, like the fee and then income, you know, the income. Each region has the potential to be developed, and then that Pak Rektor already mentioned, and then I think Dr. Dennis and then Dr. Chumpon as well as Pak Konsul already seen was what the Sulbar potential, not related to the natural resources, and then of course the other particular the people in Sulawesi Barat. What assets does Sulawesi Barat have? In here, we'd like to give you guys. I think the Pak Rektor already gave a few things related to the what the Sulawesi Barat has. Related to the potential and then asset. So let me show the few big pictures about what the local community actually exists in Sulawesi Barat. The first one is, I think Sulawesi Barat is close to the marine, close to the, I think this is called it the maritime region. So, you know, of course, a lot of a community from the sea, for example, like the fish, you know, one kind of the fish in Sulawesi Barat. And then I took the picture, was that I saw every morning in Majene and in Poloman as well. So, a lot of fish kind of this in Sulawesi Barat. And this is also, this is the flying fish that Pak Rektor already present about the bakso, was that sausage, you know, sausage from the flying fish. So I think we need Pak Konsul and Mr. Chuan and then Mr. Dennis, you know, maybe how to make the fees not only for make the process but make the products so from this is fees, because every year I don't know exactly what the how much, you know, how many ton and what's that a product of the flying fish in silver, but I think overproduction. I think overproduction. So the next, this is the octopus. I think you can find everywhere in Sulawesi Barat also. When I visit Singapore and Malaysia as well as Thailand, so I saw this is the product. But in Sulawesi Barat, this is octopus only, you know, only cook, you know, only cook. We without without produce to export something like that. I think by consulate in Songkla and then also by Dr. Dennis and Dr. Chumpan as well. Can help us, you know, to make this is the octopus better, you know, as a product for export. This is the mandar sarong. This is the mandar sarong. You call the silk sarong. I think so. Pak Rektor will present about this one. The next, this is the kind of the sarong, mandar sarong. This is the. We call it the gula merah. You know that this is gula merah. I think this is similar to the what's that? This is the brown sugar in Thailand, I think. But maybe the color is this is a dark. You know, more dark than in Thailand, I think. And this is so sweet, and also the taste is unique. The taste is unique. But unfortunately, this is only produced in here and then consumed by the local people. I think so. We can export to Thailand, of course, because every year, I don't know, every day, I think the Thai people, you know, use the brown sugar for cooking or maybe what's that? Yeah, for cooking, for making tom yum or others maybe. Because this is very important, and then some time as well. Okay, next. This is the package. You know, we have a make from the gula merah, also the brown sugar, and then next book. And then this is the coconut. I think so. Sulawesi Barat also now buy the coconut. 1,000 hectare, I think, coconut tree we can find in Sulawesi Barat. So one product of this is coconut is the oil mandar. Next, this is the oil mandar. This is kind of the what's that? The oil, I think, this is the smell is good. This smells very good, Pak Konsul, but. we don't know, don't make the produce a lot, but maybe we need the investor to, you know, to make this is a famous, I think, as a national product, because the taste and then the smell is very good. Next one, of course, we reach also the banana in Sulawesi Barat. This is the kind of the banana, and this is as well. This is the one of the cake, I think it's famous also in Mandar. We call it the kasipi, you know. And next book, this is kind of that. We look at that. Mr. Dennis and then Mr. Chumpon. This without packaging, so we need, of course, of what's that packaging? So more, maybe will be better, I think, to sell this is product. This is the coffee, you know. This is the coffee. I think we developed now the local coffee. It's called the Kura coffee. I think it's different with Mamasa and then Toraja coffee. And then next, this is the package of the Kapi Kura. One day, I think if you visit us in here, I will bring all of you to visit the place of the Kapi Kura, Kapi Kura plantation. And then this is the coconut. This is the cocoa. You know, this is the cocoa. I think Sulawesi Barat also famous with this is a plant. And then 1,000 hectare, you know, the cacao plantation. I think we can find in this area. This is the one product from the cacao powder, from the cacao. This is cacao powder actually developed by one. Was that like the local factory? I think in Sulawesi Barat. Thank you very much. I think this is my presentation. All of you hopefully inspired, and then what you have to do for help us in Sulawesi. Particular in Unsulbar, you know, Pak Konsul Dr. Chumpon and then Dr. Dennis. Thank you very much, all of you participants. This is my short presentation. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Terima kasih, Bapak Dr. Muhammad Nasir Budi, Assistant to the President for Community Services from Universitas Sulawesi Barat, to give information about the community in local, especially in Sulawesi Island. We can see a lot of local commodity to have a lot of potential to develop the products. Next, we move to the next presentation. I would like to invite Assistant Professor Dr. Tuan Tong Kruchon, Assistant to the President for Academic Services and Community Affairs from Thaksin University, to give a talk in the topic of OTOP, entrepreneurship in new normal era. Please welcome. Please welcome Dr. Tuan Tong. Excuse me, Dr. Tuan Tong, are you here?
So I'm so sorry. Okay. Very good morning, Pak Kong Soon, Pak Rector, and very good morning, Dr. Nasir Badu from Indonesia. And say hello for Thai lecturer also. And today I would like to share about our experience. I and Dr. Chumpon will share some experience in Thailand, especially in the local products. And also we will give aspect for Indonesia a little bit, because of we used to see many products in Indonesia, especially in Majene, because of we visit there more than 3 times. We thought that Majene is in West Sulawesi is one of potential area bit to develop the local product, and we think that we will collaborate and encourage the people who live in the rural area will move up to create the products, especially for the the professional products. I think it's not only the raw material, but we will move up about the brands and packaging. So that's why today we will share about the idea for developing the products in Majene in Indonesia. So before I stated in the idea, we will give you a little bit for the idea in Thailand. Especially in Thailand, we have the conceptual framework about the local product that we call OTOP. And now we are promoting the OTOP to be the national products also. And we will develop the entrepreneur for the for selling on promoting the products in our country by the concept of marketing that everybody know. Philip Koller mentioned that about the marketings that it is the science and arts. That is why we try to mix together for our products, the local products, with the science and art. Okay. For our concept that based on the Philip Kotler, we still implemented the concept of mechanic mix. We need to produce the product and we think about the price. We try to find a place, and also we will promote our product to the large market, not only in Thailand, but for international market also. Okay, and one thing that we try to run nowadays, we need to make it, it is the brand. Because brand is more power nowadays, especially the it can be transformed a brand to be the price or the money also. That is why we think about the brand. Okay, in Thailand we have the concepts of OTOP, one tambon, one product. This our idea. We accepted, we adopted idea from Japan that Japan used the inspiration from Japan successful one village, one products or OWAP program since year 2000. We try to adopt this idea from Japan and move it up to our product. Finally, OTOP Marketing try to create the route for developing. This is our route for developing our product. The first step, we try to develop the product, especially quality, taste, color, or image. This is the first stage for us. And now we move to the professional stage, that is, brand and package. And now today, during COVID-19, and also after this situation, I think we work hard to the new concept. It is a promotion. We try to make it up like the upskill for the entrepreneur in advertising, marketing, and also the seller. This is the root of our marketing, especially for OTOP. Okay. For the new normals, we change or we transform our idea also. The first step, we started with the small and medium enterprise or entrepreneurs. Now we try to move to innovation driven entrepreneurs or IDE. We try to transform from just only the product, but we move it up, especially the package. We read the package, many products, because of it, make it high value. Something like that. This is a dry banana. From only dry banana, we try to create the news package because of the products, professional and promotion have to think about this and make it together. And then we will success. Okay. We have to think about the one thing, that is the price and value together. The value come from the custom could not evaluate value from views or price. That is why we think that we need to attract to the values of the people or the customer. And we think about the price after this. Because if you can touch the values in the heart of the customer, you can make the price. That is why this is our strategy that I would like to share with you. One thing that we work hard during the COVID-19 or pandemic now, we need to upskill trainings and to find the international market for Thai's product. And also I think we can suggest to the product in Indonesia also, what is a upskill course or training in Thailand? We have online seller course. This is our process in training. One of the course is online sellers. We try to upskill the entrepreneur who are the rural people to understand what is online seller and how to be with the course. And we need them to understand the application for online selling. Nowadays, we have a lot of the application and why we have to choose the best one and how to use it. This is our suggestions for the entrepreneur in our country, in my country. Yep. With the lecturer from the university. This is all of them are the lecturer from the university. They try to build it up, the skill for the people or for the entrepreneur. And the third course is how to take a great photo, this product photo, because this is a strategy, but you have a good product, but very weak for the photo, product photo. Sometimes you are unsuccessful. To deliver in the market. This is our example. That is why we can copy and develop this idea into Majene, Amture, and three courses can prepare by Universitas Sulawesi Baras, Amture, because of a university, it's high potential to develop the entrepreneurs. One courses is online seller. We the second course is how to use application online, and the third one, how to take a great photo, product photo. This is very important. Okay, this is one thing that I would like to show you. Oh, when we saw this picture, maybe we need to touch it, right? Banana. With the new pictures, not, yeah. This one's also the crispy, rolling crispy, like in Indonesia that Dr. Nasibadu showed that, okay? This is our textiles or fabric that made from the people who live in the rural area also, okay? And for the international market, our market, will touch in China nowadays. This is one of the examples of Thai products in the in the China market. We try to export most of the products into China, and we have to prepare the package also. Okay, this is the one of example is pineapple. Okay, and also we have to learn how to develop the products, the rural products from Japan. Not only learning from online, but we have to touch the real things. To when we have the course for the people, for the entrepreneur, we understand the concept of Japan. One thing that I would like to share you: environment effect to souvenir product, like in Ochinu Hokkai village in Japan. That nearby the Fujiyama mountain, right? They let you see, they can create the village to be the tourist destination. And we prepare the souvenir shop inside the village. That is why in Thailand, we adopt this idea to create the innovation way for OTOPS and village also. Mixed together between tourist destinations and the local product together. This is the one thing, the souvenir product from Japan in this village that you know is nearby the Fujiyama mountain. That is why we prepare the cookies, the snack, the shapes look like the mountain. Not only the shapes of the circles or the triangle, but we need they need to change the shape to be the mountain that look like Fujiyama to be the souvenir products. Most of people, especially the tourists, when we went to this village, we brought it to be the souvenir for friends and family. And they have many style of the cookies, the shapes of the mountain. That you see, and they take a symbol, take a picture, the mountain to be the symbol of the products also. And especially even in the international airport, they try to promote the local product with the very beautiful package. That is why the package is very important that you see. Okay. Many things that we borrow, we accepted, we borrow from Japan. That is why we learn more about the concept from Japan. This is my idea to you for to share my experience. And one thing that I would like to share you, when we have the good product, when we have a good packaging, one thing that you have to do the promotion, especially the media that we have to create the media to transform your picture, our picture to online channel. This is the one thing that's important that I would like to share with you around just a few minutes. Okay. 2 minutes for sharing about our media in online.
บัดนี้ได้สุภฤกษ์ต้องเบิกเนตรอันเป็นเหตุให้เกิดเรื่องหันษาอันว่านอนอนุมานเดินผ่านมาละลานตาเมืองกระบี่มีมากมาย
Thank you. Amazing Thailand!
มาเที่ยวกระบี่บ้านหนูกันเยอะๆนะคะ
บัดนี
้โอเค this is one of the example we can create in Indonesia. I thought that after this maybe Dr. Chumpun will share about his experience and also he will give a little bit the idea from his experience in Indonesia also like me. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much for Assistant Professor Dr. Dr. Chuan Thong Krutjohn, Assistant to the President for Academic Services and Community Affairs from Thaksin University. We already listened to the information about from Professor Chuan Thong. After this, I think we would like now invite Assistant Professor Dr. Chumpon Angkananon from Macquarie University, Chumpon Campus, to give a talk about his experience in product development, especially in community, as well as also opportunity to develop community products with his perspective, especially case in Chumpon and how to apply in Majene, Sulawesi. Please welcome Dr. Chumpon Angkananon.
Hello. Sawadee krap. Good morning, everybody. Good morning, all our professor and student from Indonesia and Thailand. I'm very glad today to talk with you. And thank you, Professor Dr. Tuan Thong, to invite me to join with you. I will show some. Can you see my PowerPoint?
Not yet.
Okay. Not yet, right? Okay, I will show you. How to do this? Wait a minute. Okay, I think okay, maybe Professor Tuan Thong, can you show me the PowerPoint? I send it to you by LINE. Professor Tuan Thong, can you hear me? Right?
Yep.
I can hear you. Okay.
Just a few minutes. Okay, I will download okay. And will be okay. The assistant for you.
All right, sorry, I think my computer got some problem.
Okay, so you have
all right, thank you very much, everyone. Thank you for Dr. Nasibadu, right? Today I will give our experience from Thailand, especially from Chumphon province, how the people in community they can develop the product, right, and how can they make the good revenue from the agricultural product. I think in the past, our country, I mean it's Thailand, we have got revenue from the tourist, from the export, the product from overseas. But now after COVID-19, is a big problem. Not only Thailand, I think every country in the world, especially the country is they have the main income from tourists or from export the product. That's why our king or our government, they have the strategy to do some project how to help the people in community to develop the product to help them, because if we only have the one revenue from country, I mean from the tourists, now we close the country, no tourism, no tourists. What happened in my country? I think a lot of people here almost die. I don't know what happened in Indonesia. I think the same as Thailand, right? In Thailand, the big problem, we cannot export. We cannot export some products to overseas and no tourists. I think almost 0%. Yeah, that's the big problem. That's why we come back to the community, because community is the base of the country. If the community strong, if the community strong, that means country is so strong, because country come from the people. Many people become to the village or become to the community. That's why today I will share experience from the Chumphon province or from my university. That's we look at the community or the people in the village. Like Professor Dr. Tuan Thong mentioned before, that it's about the product. Yeah, the product back to the product of the community, especially in Indonesia. Many times I have been to Indonesia, especially Majene. It's a beautiful place, right? Very beautiful place, and a lot of material fish from the sea. You risk of the material. I think I cannot imagine how rich can you be, right? If you can manage the product or material, that's one. Or many things like coconuts. Also in Thailand, we import coconut from your country, right? A lot of coconut in Thailand, sometimes we import and make it become to coconut milk and the product from coconuts. And after we make it and we export to your country again. That's right. That's the real thing. Also some country like Malaysia. In Thailand, some we have many material, like material from agriculture is like a corn, right? Jackfruits or many things. We export the raw material to some country in the world, in Malaysia, Indonesia, or some. And after they make become to product. I example like this one. You can look at this one. It's a cocoa. Also, my country can produce the cocoa, and some we can export to your country. Or this one, coffee. Sorry. The coffee, we have a lot of coffee. we send the raw material to some country, America or Europe, and after they make the product, they send back to my country more value, and I have to pay, our country have to pay more value, more money to this product. That's the point that I would like to tell you, tell everyone, especially the student in our Zoom today. How can we make more value of our product? If we send only the raw material, we have problem. Or right now, if we cannot export to some country, we can contribute the product in domestic or in our country, in Indonesia. How many population? I think almost 280 or 300 million people. Can you imagine how big the market you can sell? Especially your country, only one country, Indonesia, almost 300 million people. Can you imagine how can you do? Or ASEAN, I mean 10 or 11 country. We have ASEAN community. Approximately 700 million people, your customer, 700 million people, and I think 2 times of your population, I think enough for the market. Yeah, you can sell everything, but not easy, like I told you, not easy to do like that, because the product is very important. Professor Tuan Tong told you, how can make more value, how can produce, how can add more value of the product. The product have to come from your village. If we start from the first, I think if we look at the country, Indonesia, have a lot of material, the raw material, but you say it's very cheap. You have to do something. You have to make it, you have to repackage, or you have to do the another thing. Yeah, packaging, or the last one, promotion. I will show you the picture. Professor Tuan Tong, next slide, please. Okay, product made from fish. You can see, you can look at the fish. The fish is in our country. We have a lot of fish. Some you can see in your country or some country, they sell is beside the road and very cheap. If you put like that and can keep too long, at least 3 months, 6 months or 1 year, you can get more value. And you know how much for one fish? I think around 1,000 baht or 35 US dollar something. Next slide, please. Yeah, next slide, please. This one also, it's very easy. The example I show you, that's the village, the people can do it. Sometimes we no need the industrial, big industrial. That means you have to put more budget, 100 million, 10 million. How can the people do it? I think impossible. But now we talk about the small entrepreneur, the small entrepreneur. The village, the people, 10 people, 20 people come to join to make it. We put some innovation, we put some technology, and you can, that fit, we can export around the world. Can keep it 6 months or 1 year. If you sell in front of your house beside the road, I think 100 baht or $2 or $1. And you can, if you make like that, very beautiful packaging. You can sell $20 or $30. Please next slide. Like that, and can keep too long. Like I told you, next slide. Yeah, next one. Please next one. Yeah, like that. Easy, I think. How to make it very easy for you. At least can keep for 1 month or 2 months or 3 months, like that. You can do by yourself. Another one is product from coconut. Indonesia is the land of coconut, I think, right? You can see, you can make a dessert, a food. This one US dollar for one box or one package. Very beautiful. If you look at, right? You would like to eat like a jelly from coconut, and you put some fruits. This one around 1.5 US dollar or one. Another one is oil, coconut oil. Very, very good product. You can use for eat, right? Maybe like for skin, something like that. Yeah, the next one. Yeah, the next one, like a soap. We can make the soap from coconut. We can do it, all of the product I show you, right? You can do it, the village can do it. Yeah, not difficult, not too difficult, right? This like a lighting, right? You make it from coconut. Okay, the next one. It's a product from Thailand. How cool they are, you can see? Like a souvenir. Some, the inside, the coconuts, right? You have the very hard one. You have to learn, not easy. You know how can teach in Thailand, we teach this one in the jail. In jail. If you would like to do, maybe you come to Thailand and you come to prisoner. The prisoner. We have the teacher come and teach the people how to make, how to do, and like a souvenir. Like a coffee shop, like some put a pen. Okay, the next one. Yeah. You can see. Easy for you. It's around almost one US dollar. Yep. The next one, sir. Yeah. The coffee from Indonesia. The good coffee. The soap, right? Soap. The next one, sir. Yep. Yeah. From banana. Indonesia also have a lot of banana. Yeah. Can you see? You know how much is one? We sell it in airport, international airport. Very expensive one. I think one small package. One small package, half of dollar, I think. Yeah, the one big box. I think almost $5. Yeah, this one. Solar dry nature banana. Around $5 for banana, and really beautiful one. Yeah, can export to many countries in the world. There's some product from durian. I think also Indonesia have durian, yeah, and good taste, right, Professor Tonto? We try many times. Yeah, durian. It's easy to make it one. Yeah, very easy to make it. The durian is a good one. Okay, that's the example of the product from Thailand. It's from Thailand, especially from the southern part of Thailand. We have many raw material. We have durian. We have many fruit. We have fish. We have some. That's why the people can make it. I show you all of the picture. The people in the village, in the community can make it by themselves. No need big industrial, no need the big company. That's why. And I think in the future, Professor Tuan Thong and our team from Thailand, we go to Manjene, we go to your country, we join. We will work together how to support, how to help the community. University is very important. Because and you, some, I think most of all is a student. Student is one of the key men to help the community, because you are the one is we call the you have knowledge, right? You know about technology. You can go to the community. You can teach him. You can tell them how to make it. University is the it's a very important, because university give more education. That's education is the very powerful weapon can help the people which live from the poor, live from the social problem. If we know, if we join Thailand, I think our country very pleasure to join, to collaboration with Indonesia to do like our country do. Yeah, I think next time we can do together. Thank you very much, Professor Tuan Tong and Dr. Badu. Okay, see you.
Thank you very much for Assistant Professor Dr. Chumphon Ankananon from Major University, Chumphon Campus, to present the information about his experience and how to increase value of local product. Nah, ini sangat penting sekali untuk mengembangkan produk lokal. Sama sekali juga di era new normal ini, cara untuk menjualkan produk lokal tidak jauh, kita sangat penting untuk cari cara untuk peluang untuk menjual lokal, produk lokal, seperti gimana untuk menarik cara foto produk yang kita punya, ya, yang dimana Dr. Tuan Tong tadi sudah kasih contoh. Nah, ya, dan juga sesi berikutnya, next, I would like to invite Achan Chontida Getpet, the head of Fine and Applied Art Program in Design, Faculty of Fine and Applied Art from Tukson University, to give information about packaging design to upgrade community products. Please welcome Achan Chontida. Chen Kap Achan.
Thank you, Achan Abdul Lakim. เดี๋ยวพี่แชร์ได้เลยใช่ไหมคะ
แชร์ได้เลยครับอาจารย์
แชร์ได้เลยครับอาจารย
์โอเคhello everyoneMr. Fatri Kongsun of the Republic of Indonesia, Songkhla, Dr. Aksan, Dr. Muhammad Nasi Bandu, Dr. Tuan Tong, and Dr. Professor Chumphon, and everyone in the morning. I am great and excited for to talk with you today. I would like to present about the packaging design as important for the product and can be to good product. Yes. In packaging design, it imagining the format and structure of the packaging in relation to the function of the product to protect product from the damage and to the psychological value to consumer by relying on both science and art in design. Yeah, this example for the general product from the marketing. Yeah.From nature and developing the product, right? And next packaging is something that support or encapsulate the product, and next to serve to protect the product from various damage and facilitate various in the transportation and storage, and next it encourages.Purchase and as well as inform product details. The packaging have important for the detail for every product. Yeah, to consumer to know what the product from the product where from. Yeah, and next the purpose of the packaging design. The first one, to create an packaging that can be useful in front of good use and safety, economical and efficient. Yeah. And next, to create an packaging sorry, to create a packaging that can communicate and make impact on consumer by using the knowledge of the arts. Create attribute such as unique, attractive, and memorable, as well as create the meaning and the benefit of the product. Yeah, and next, the last one, to product and the maintain product quality. Yeah, is next. Number four, add an indicator and communicate product detail, attract consumer, show the image of product. Yeah, and next, it is the cost of producing to the product. When the packaging is good, it help to increase the value of the product. Yeah, and the picture is the example for the packaging development from nature, from the local material. Yeah, some product, some packaging from the from Japan, nah, and from Thailand too. Yeah. So the importance of packaging. Yeah. The first one, packaging is the maintain the quality and protect the product. Our product want to protect. Yeah. And next, number two, product is convenient in transportation. If you want to sell product to another local or country, you must to have transportation. So the packaging is important for this. Yeah. And next, the last one for important packaging, to promote marketing. Yeah. The packaging, beautiful packaging or can to information to detail of the product. Consumer can know how, what's in the box. Yeah. Next, function and role of packaging. Yeah. The first one, packaging to serve as a support product. Yeah. Next, second one, protect your product. Third, act as and treatment your product. Yeah. Number four, indicate or inform information to product. Yeah. And number five, packaging attract attention to product. Next, increase profit or create add value. And the last one, the packaging can promotion up sell your product. If you want to develop main of the product, you must to have a good packaging by using packaging at a marketing strategy, and then find the need of the target audience, and then meet the needs. It means design the packaging for the product and to sell. Yeah, it become to profit of product. Yes. Next one, resort used in packaging design. The first one, market information. Packaging design must take into account the principle and technique of the marketing, which concept of goal setting, safety, marketing, planning, sales, promotion. And next, must know how to arrange and the atmosphere of the distribution at the point of sale. Yeah. Next, number two, product information to be packed the packaging design will be successful when the designer is aware of the feature of the product itself. Outstanding feature of the product that will meet the need of the customer target group. It is absolutely necessary that must be built, otherwise we'll never know what to offer to meet the need of buyer or target group. And next number, third, target group or buyer. Maybe the consumer of the product itself or not being a consumer, like design, must know the need of the target audience, the state of the consumer that should be taken into account in as follow: gender, age, income, status, or livelihood, belief, or faith. And next, number four, regulation. In the case of food packaging in Thailand, export in Thailand, the government organization that play a role in the overseeing is the Food and Drug Administration or FDA. For food product packaged in the sealed container, permission in the required from the Food and Drug Administration with a serial number in Thailand. Yes, we call all your for the support about the food product. Yeah. Next, number five, distribution channel, retail, wholesale, or direct sale. And last, various sale channel, it will determine the packaging style. The example, the packaging development for the now. Next, number six, competition condition. Competitor retention is essential to keep packaging and the design to be superior to competitor under the condition of distribution channel or point of sale that is true. This is the some example product for development and before and this after. Yeah. Number seven, environmental consideration. Using environmentally friendly packaging gets more attention from the urban community. Packaging design using material can recycle product, can reduce waste and are easy to dispose of. Therefore, it a selling point to promote sale as well. Yeah. For the food packaging design, we need to we have a concept of packaging development objective. Five W plus two S analysis. Yeah. One. Why, what event of the factor led to the need to redesign to packaging, or why development packaging, or why not modify, improve, develop something else instead. Next, number two, who is red possible for the development. This packaging, who are the people or department in love? And next, number three, where will the product be sold? When we have the product, we have development packaging. We must to know where the product will be sold. Yeah. And next, what is the purpose of the packaging development? What are the design limitations? And what the selling point of the product? And last, what is the use of packaging? We use the packaging from natural material or material from in the market. Yeah. And the last W, when should the development work begin? When will the development be complete? And when is it on the market? It is the 5W. And 2S, how? What technology will be used to make a packaging? Easy or difficult or technology or by the people in the community, yeah? And the last one for 5W and 2H, how much will it cost to develop? What is the budget for packaging? Some place, some community have a little bit for the budget or money to the development of the packaging, because some packaging is expensive for make. So we just to know we can bring the material or technology in the community, we can do, or people in the local can do. Yeah, so we can low price of the packaging. Yeah. The answer given to this 5W2H question lead to objective setting goal for the packaging development. And this example, the curry paste in Thailand, before they use the plastic and mud, and now they can develop the packaging to the better. This packaging is the designer Betty Bangka. It good excellent design from the DMARC Award. Yeah, did the packaging of curry paste. Yeah. And next function of graphic on packaging. Yeah. Packaging have a structure and material and the graphic on it. The one create a good attitude to what product and manufacturer, and second, clarify and indicate to consumer the type of product type, and next, show a unique in identity for the product and operator, and the last page show property and how to use the product. This is the function of graphic, and the good packaging have to one as simple and aesthetic and function and economic for the good product and packaging. Yeah, it called safe. Next page, community packaging design guideline for I think for the product, local product. Yeah. The first one, form and packaging material should convey the meaning of the local origin of the manufacturer of product. Yeah. Next, selection of the local material as the main packaging material or auxiliary material. And next, environmental consideration in the packaging production process. And next, production of packaging with locally available technology, if you can do it by yourself. Present and future consider the packaging for transportation. And the last one, graphic representation of local story or culture. Yeah, storytelling about the local, your local, about the origin product. I think it's the interested and can be more detail for the product. And the next is the exception for the community packaging design guideline it from our student and my lecturer. They go to work with the community in Thailand, in Songkhla, in Pathalung province. Yeah, the first one, this is the packaging of ice cream Nangam at Nangam Road, Songkhla province. He designed from the culture, from the identity in the Songkhla Road, and designed to the graphic and color for the packaging of Aitim Ong is the name of the ice cream at most popular in the Thanon Nangam Road in Songkhla. Yeah. And the next one, design packaging for the pineapple head product from Thung Nari sub-district, Pabon district, Pathalung province. This is the packaging for my student to he design from the pineapple farm, and the man, like a man of Thai Southern. Yeah, it is the packaging development. Yeah. And then next, it is the packaging for Maori jam. It is development by my student too. And next, this is the packaging for banana. Yeah, design the branding and graphic and packaging. And next, this is the packaging for tea, na le tea or cha na le. And next, this is the packaging for banana too. It's the kway chap, glop keo. And this is packaging for the jam from Marbury. And this one is packaging of jelly mulberry. It's been rebrand and development packaging too. Yes. Talk about or today for a package, importance of packaging and role of packaging and some example for development of me and my student for you. The work, and thank you for I'm present. Yes, I think okay. Yeah, thank you for for my
presentation.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much, Achan Chontida Ketpet, the Head of Fine and Applied Art Program in Design, Faculty of Fine and Applied Art from Thaksin University, to give to give us a presentation about packaging design to upgrade community products. Kita bisa lihat tadi yang mana desain kotak-kotaknya yang begitu menarik ya, yang gimana cara pakai warnanya dan juga cost-nya. Nah itu salah satu untuk bisa meningkatkan nilai produk lokal. Dan apa banyak lagi yang semua speaker kita yang sudah kasih information pada hari ini. Thank you very much for our speakers today. And again, I would like to give thanks to our speakers today to give information. And we now have a time for a question from our participant who want to have a question. So please, now we have a time for give a session for question. Di sini kalau punya pertanyaan juga bisa dengan bahasa Indonesia, nanti saya terjemahkan dengan bahasa Thailand. Kalau pertanyaannya kepada speaker dari Thailand, ya silakan. Sebelum kita menuju ke sisi terakhir, yaitu conclusion dari our speakers, nanti sebelum itu mungkin di sini kalau partisipan dari mau partisipan yang dari Indonesia atau from Thailand, nah, you can also give a question to us for our speakers today.
Izin Pak Abdul Hakim, boleh saya ikut sebentar ya, untuk menyapa kawan saya lagi di tanah air. Terima kasih Pak Rektor masih bersama kita. Alhamdulillah Pak Nasir, Pak rekan-rekan, dan ada juga dinas-dinas, dan juga ada dari Hasanuddin tadi belum tersapa oleh saya, Pak. Terima kasih telah hadir. Satu hal yang mau saya sampaikan, acara ini bagus sekali, Pak Rektor, Pak Nasir. Kita bisa mendekatkan informasi kepada rekan-rekan kita. Pertanyaan kita adalah PR kita, sebelum saya lupa, saya sering lupa nih, Pak. Ini kita harus mendekatkan memang teknologi kepada komunitas kita, Pak Rektor. Bagaimana Unsur Bar bisa menjadi pionir dalam hal ini. Saya tahu tantangan Bapak di kabupaten itu berat sekali, Pak. Biasanya universitas itu memang harus ada di pusat kekuasaannya. Tapi ini Unsur Bar berbeda sendiri, berada di kabupaten, dan ini tentu perjuangannya tidak sedikit juga. Tadi beberapa pembicara dari Pak Danis, Pak Cumpon, dan juga Ibu Cetida ini, kita dekat sekali berurusan dengan teknologi, ya. Nah, ini barangkali saya lihat ada Dinas Perdagangan dan Koperasi Polman juga hadir, dan juga dinas-dinas tadi. Ini tolong saran saya, karena ini acara cukup bagus, dan Bapak Rektor dan saya serta Taksim University, Cumpon University, Major University, ini adalah stakeholder-stakeholder yang menurut hemat saya patut didengar. Kalau saya fasilitator lah, saya birokrat ya. Tapi ini perguruan tinggi mau melakukan sesuatu, Bapak Kepala Dinas, ini adalah hal yang perlu kita jemput bola, Pak Kepala Dinas atau Ibu Kepala Dinas di Kabupaten dan Kota. Jika seandainya bisa, ini kita harus, tentu Unsur Bar tidak mungkin ambil alih secara penuh. Ini harus disambut oleh birokrat kita di Kabupaten Kota. Sedikit saja tadi. Terima kasih. Lanjutkan, mungkin ada yang mau bertanya, Pak. Teman-teman silakan banyak.
Izin Pak, di sini ya. Juga ada dari UM Pak.
Dari
UM Pak.
Oh iya.
UM Malaysia, Dr. Zaki Pak.
Oh selamat bergabung Bapak Dr. Zaki ya. Terima kasih ya. Silakan teman-teman yang dari Mandar, masyarakat kita yang hadir dalam kegiatan ini atau any Thailand participant, please join. Abdul Hakim will translate your language. Terima kasih. Okay. Contida tadi sudah kasih nice word, safe ya. Simple, aesthetic, function, and economic. Yeah. Dan ingat Bapak Ibu, apapun produk Anda, tanpa marketing yang baik, tanpa packaging yang kekinian, itu tidak akan laku. Nah, ini kira-kira yang ingin kita sampaikan message ini. Silakan.
Ya, terima kasih Bapak. Oke, okay, please welcome. We have a question. ถ้ามีนักศึกษาจากประเทศไทยนะครับถ้าต้องการถามก็สามารถถามได้นะครับเดี๋ยว
Abdul Hakim itu ada dari Disper Indak Polman yang lagi raise hand.
Oke, okay. Silakan. Ini yang raise hand dari Perindakop.
Ya,
silakan.
Oke, okay, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
And good morning everyone. Okay, first of all, I would like to say thanks to, for the opportunity they given to me. So, in this occasion, I would like to ask to Mr. Chumpong about the biggest struggle the small medium enterprise in Thailand face through. So, my question is, what the biggest struggle small medium enterprise in Thailand that face through? For example, in my region, yeah, Polewali Mandar, our biggest struggle is sometimes our small medium enterprise know how to make a product, but don't know how to sell it. And vice versa, sometimes they do know what the consumer wants, but don't know how to make it the product the consumer wants it. So can you give me explain about it in your perspective in Thailand, small medium enterprise in Thailand? Thank you.
Thank you for the good questions. อาจารย์ชุมพลเชิญครับ
ครับครับผมไม่ค่อยได้ยินสัญญาณครับอาจารย์
can you please ask again
อาจารย์เปลยเลยก็ได้เดี๋ยวผมได้ยินนิดหน่อยเรื่องอะไรนะเรื่องนโยบายหรืออะไรนะอาจารย์ว่าทำไมทำได้ใช่ไหมขาดหายถามว่าไงนะครับ
The biggest struggle or big problem that small medium enterprise in Thailand face through. It is my question.
ธุรกิจขนาดเล็กขนาดกลางเขาทำยังไงใช่ไหมครับ
เป็นมีปัญหาอะไรบ้างครับที่เกิดขึ้น
มีปัญหาที่เกิด
ที่ถูกเผชิญใช่ครับผม
โอเค all right thank you for the question very good question so actually in Thailand we have a lot of problem is about the SME, we call SME, small medium enterprise. Yep, that's why. Who is the key man? I think it's the government. Government is the main factor is the hero to help the people here. You know what happened in Thailand? Sometimes when the people can produce or make some product, they don't know how to do it, right? Who will do? University or some organization under the government go to the community to help the people, to teach them, to train the people how to make the product. And after make already some of product in Thailand, we have a lot. How can we do it? How can we sell it? We have no market, right? Because Thailand is just a small country, not as big as Indonesia country. Some product, they don't know how to attribute the product. Government is the man who have to do it because the government, they control the policy. They are the policy maker of government. They are the coordinator to join, to ask the big company, like a shopping mall. In example, in my village, in Chumphon, some of season, we have like a durian. We have a lot of durian. We have a lot of mangosteen. This year, you know, mangosteen are very cheap, just 3 baht or half, how to, 10 kilo, $1, something like that. For 10 kilo, $1. What happened? You know, government have to do it because this is the policy because this is the authority. Government have authority to do it. They have to find the market for the people to support it. Maybe they find a new market from the overseas or in the shopping mall. Some the durian or is the mango tea. We have a lot in the southern part of Thailand. They have to send out to the northern part of Thailand. We have to send to the center, to Bangkok. Logistic, government have to do about logistic. Or maybe we make some like a yam mangosteen or like a mangosteen juice, something like that. Government ask university, government ask someone to come to make the more value of the mangosteen, something like that. And something is about the budget. The community have no budget. Government will give the loan. The loan money is a very cheap interest, very cheap debt fund for here. Some they give for free. Some budget, the government subsidize or support the budget for free. That's why the government is the hero to do it, because government is the policy maker. We have to join, we have to do with the government, we have to do with the university. Okay, right.
Thank you. Can answer it. Okay. Thank you.
All right, thank you very much.
Supon, very interesting. I like the last word, ya. Ini Pak Disperindak, kok Anda mesti catat ini. You can be a hero, bro. Provoke you how to be hero in this new normal. Yeah, so government.
Yeah.
Make a Dr. Aksan. So you should visit your the university frequently. Not find the young student lah to meet the Dr. Badu, Dr. Aksan. What is the best way? This, yes, that's correct. It is in Thailand. I can share with you, bro, that in Thailand it's now buy a product. They send to the hospital, they send to the prison, they send to the military camp, and then everybody happy. Nah, ini mungkin jadi catatan, Pak. Jadi kita harus, memang Bapak harus bekerja keras ya, karena pemimpin-pemimpin daerah tadi yang dikatakan Bapak Rektor, kan pemimpin daerah politikus, dan program, saya tahu ada pasti yang baik juga, toh. Nah, jadi dengan Pak Nasirnya kak sering-sering ketemu ini kan Pak 80 sering-sering juga ketok ruangan Pak Rektor. How the best way Pak, how to ya man, Polman itu saya terkesan sekali, saya nggak tahu kalau Mandar itu bersebelahan dengan Polman ya, ternyata usul bar ini memang strategis sekali. Satu universitas dia mengayomi satu provinsi bahkan dua kabupaten tersebut. Thank you very much. Mungkin lanjutkan Pak Kim, ada yang mau tanya.
Ya. Terima kasih. Maybe two questions would like to ask. Saya dapat pertanyaan dari chatting, tapi tidak tahu pertanyaannya menuju ke siapa.
Dibaca saja Pak, dibaca saja.
Oke, okay. Di sini pertanyaannya info apa saja yang ditulis di kemasan suatu produk untuk dapat menarik minat konsumen.
Ibu Contida itu yang harus jawab, Bu Contida. Okay.
Pertanyaannya nanti saya terjemahkan ke bahasa Thailand dulu. Acan Contida ครับ มี คำ ถาม จาก นัก ศึกษา นะ ครับ จาก มหาวิทยาลัย Sulawesi Barat นะ ครับ ถาม ว่า มี ข้อมูล อะไร บ้าง ที่ ต้อง ใส่ ใน ในแพ็กเกจนะครับเพื่อให้สินค้าที่เราจะนำมาจำหน่ายเนี่ยเกิดความมีแรงจูงใจ
okay.
ข้อมูลอะไรบ้างครับผม
ค่ะพี่ตอบเป็นภาษาไทยอาจารย์ซัมสลิดให้นะ
ได้ครับได้ครับ
ค่ะก็สำหรับข้อมูลนะคะข้อมูลที่เราจะบรรจุลงบนบรรจุภัณฑ์นะคะหรือว่าแพ็กเกจิ้งของโปรดักต์ต่างๆเนี่ยหนึ่งเลยเราต้องมีสิ่งที่มันสามารถจดจำได้เป็นอันดับแรกนะคะก็คือ branding นะคะหรือว่าชื่อสินค้าตราสินค้านะคะเหมือนที่อาจารย์ยกตัวอย่างกันมาทุกท่านเลยเนี่ยเราจะเห็นว่ามันต้องมีชื่อสินค้านะคะกล้วยเบรกแตกอะไรแบบนี้นะคะสมมุติแล้วก็เรื่องของวันเดือนปีท ที่ผลิตถ้าเป็นในเรื่องของพวกอาหารนะคะแหล่งผลิตนะคะแล้วก็สตอรี่หรือว่าเรื่องราวของผลิตภัณฑ์นะคะลักษณะพิเศษเฉพาะของผลิตภัณฑ์หรือแม้กระทั่งเป็นเรื่องราวเป็นสตอรี่ของชุมชนก็ได้ค่ะของท้องถิ่นที่บรรจุลงไปมันเป็นเหมือนกับคนสนใจเห็นแล้วก็ทราบเรื่องราวของที่มาที่ไปของผลิตภัณฑ์ด้วยอะค่ะอันนี้นะคะก็คือมีตัวตราสินค้าหรือว่าแบรนดิ้งนะคะมีเรื่องของพวกข้อมูลต่างๆที่บังคับโดยหน่วยงานราชการหรือว่าทางรัฐนะคะพวกข้อมูลที่เกี่ยวกับพวกสินค้าควรจะมีนะคะแล้วก็เรื่องของสตอรี่ของผลิตภัณฑ์นะคะแล้วก็กราฟิกลวดลายที่สวยงามแล้วก็สีสันรวมไปถึงโครงสร้างลักษณะรูปแบบของบรรจุภัณฑ์ที่สามารถจะดึงดูดเตะเขาเรียกว่าเตะตาคนที่จะซื้อหรือว่าหยิบไปได้ค่ะ
ขอบคุณครับjadi jawaban dari Achan Chonchita poinnya 5 ya salah satunya yaitu pertama kali branding ya untuk menarik produk yang ini yaitu branding ya. Pas kita lihat itu kita sudah tahu brandingnya apa, nah produknya apa gitu kan. Yang kedua yaitu ini tanggal, nah dan sumber produknya dari mana gitu ya, dan apa yang lain lagi yaitu yang pentingnya yaitu story. Nah yang ketiga itu story. Kadang-kadang kalau punya story dari produk itu membuat sangat menarik juga produk yang kita buat. Nah, kemudian grafiknya, nah grafiknya, cara packagingnya, nah bentuk packagingnya, nah ini semuanya adalah yang penting untuk bisa menarik konsumen untuk membeli produk kita. Nah, terima kasih.
Very good. Thank you very much. Boleh saya tambah sedikit saja, ini saya sudah menjadi orang Thailand ini.
Ya, Pak.
Tadi waktu Dr. Chupon menjelaskan kepada teman-teman, ada satu produk tentang ikan asin. Ya. Itu ikan asin packagingnya sederhana saja, ditutup dengan kertas koran, plastik. Tapi ada hal yang menjadikan ikan itu yang tadinya murah, sekarang harganya 500-600 baht. Nama ikan itu ikan
pulau.
Apa historinya? Saya mau jelaskan Pak Badu. Pak Badu pasti sudah menikmati, Pak Rektor pasti sudah menikmati ikan asin itu. Ikan asin itu kononnya adalah ikan kesukaan keluarga kerajaan. Ketika keluarga kerajaan mengetahui harganya murah, maka dibikinlah cerita dan dibikin cara pengolahannya yang sehat. Kemudian dianjurkan masyarakat membeli dan sekarang ikan itu mahal. Kalau Bapak pergi ke Andaman, ke Laut Cina Selatan, ikan itu dijual di pinggir jalan, simple sekali dan jauh lebih bagus packaging yang tadi Pak Badu, yang ikan presto di Semarang umpamanya, jauh lebih bagus. Tapi ini dicari orang. Dan menjadi oleh-oleh yang top. Story. Very thank you. Kapko makap, contida. You explain to my fellows here. Oke, Pak Kim. Saya nih suka sekali ini seperti ini ya. Ini barangkali semuanya sudah tahu ya. Ada apa namanya? Ada produk-produk yang branding, the first branding. Kemudian yang kedua grafik, tanggal. Tanggal itu penting untuk ini masih baik atau tidak. Kemudian kalau di Thailand Selatan, more specific, halal itu spesifik sekali. Ya, so. Optimis, Pak Dinas Peradaban Koperasi, kita harus maju ini ya. Oke.
Okay. Terima kasih Pak Fajri. Mungkin satu lagi pertanyaan. One question.
Ya, Pak Rektor, want to say something.
Oke, okay. Yes please.
Ya, terima kasih Pak Abdul Hakim. Ya. Jadi Pak Konsul ini,
ya,
Pak. Unsul Bar ini ada di Kabupaten Majene. Kabupaten Majene ini adalah kota tua. Jadi dulu ibu kota Abdeling, ya, bahasa kerajaan gitu. Abdeling Mandar. Nah, wilayah Mandar ini dari Pulau Wali Mandar sampai ke perbatasan Sulawesi Tengah, Pak.
Siap.
Nah, oleh sebab itu masyarakatnya itu adalah petani dan nelayan. Jadi memang kita kalau di Thailand misalnya yang saya amati itu ada pengelompokan masyarakat. Ada yang nelayan, ada yang petani, tetapi ada yang juga banyak yang memiliki keterampilan yang memanfaatkan jasa. Misalnya di sekitar floating market, ya itu di utara gitu. Kemudian tadi yang ditampilkan oleh Dr. Koton itu yang masyarakat mungkin di daerah dekat Phuket atau di daerah wisata di Pattaya atau di pokoknya itu semua yang berbasis pada jasa. Nah, kita ini kalaupun jasa itu tematiknya seperti tadi sarung sutra, kemudian yang produk pertanian itu yang petani murni itu seperti tadi kakao sama kopi. Kopi Arabica juga dari kita enak, Pak. Selain kopi Arabica Toraja ya. Jadi Toraja Arabica sama Mamasa Arabica ataupun tadi itu ada Kura Arabica itu tesnya juga spesifik. Jadi kemudian ada ikan asin. Ikan asin ini juga kami kalau di wilayah Sulawesi Selatan itu terkenal itu ikan asin dari Mandar. Jadi brand Mandar ini sebenarnya kalau di Sulawesi Selatan itu sudah pisang Mandar, minyak kelapa Mandar, kelapa Mandar, kelapanya sendiri. Itu menjadi branding, Pak, di
Mandar sudah, ya, Mandar. Mandar brandingnya Mandar ya itu Pak Rektor ya.
Apalagi sarung Mandar yang sampai di Sumatera gitu menjadi lambang kerajaan itu, Pak, yang
betul.
Yang ada di pundaknya orang Padang itu sarung Mandar itu.
Siap, betul.
Memang terkenalnya sarung Bugis.
Sarung Bugis.
Jadi seperti itulah. Tapi ya nggak apa-apa, kita pelan-pelan menyampaikan bahwa ini adalah sarung Mandar. Jadi itu yang kita hadapi. Saya sekarang ini sedang sama-sama dengan Dinas Perindustrian dari Kabupaten Polewali Mandar. Jadi ada di samping saya duduk. Beliau katanya tidak bagus jaringannya di Pulau Wali, jadi langsung ke ruangan rektor nih sama-sama saya, Pak.
Iya.
Ya nanti akan bertanya. Nah, kami punya lab IT yang cukup bagus, Pak Zul, jadi untuk bisa kirim-kirim gagasan, desain-desain dan sebagainya. Kami punya lab IT yang cukup bagus, Pak. Jadi bisa dimanfaatkan itu meskipun kami jauh, seperti tadi dikatakan bukan di ibu kota provinsi, tapi alhamdulillah infrastruktur informasi dan sebagainya seperti lab tadi itu kita sudah miliki, Pak, jadi kita bisa tidak terlalu susah untuk mengirimkan informasi desain yang mungkin cukup besar katakanlah pulsa dan sebagainya itu bisa kita atasi. Jadi kira-kira seperti itu, Pak Konsul. Insya Allah kami bisa melaksanakan itu dengan baik. Terima kasih Pak Abdul Hakim ya. Terima kasih.
Ya, ya Pak. Terima kasih. Terima kasih Pak Hasan Jalaluddin.
Pak Hakim ada lagi
Pak Rektor.
Nyambung Pak.
Iya, masih ada kan? Oke, silakan Pak.
Mas, kesempatan yang diberikan, kami, saya mewakili Dinas Perindustrian Perdagangan Koperasi dan UMKM Kabupaten Polewali Mandar. Kebetulan saya di Kepala Seksi Industri Makanan dan Minuman. Di sini perlu saya sampaikan, Pak, bahwa di Kabupaten Polewali Mandar itu ada 14 kecamatan, itu 7 di daerah pegunungan, 7 di pesisir. Kemudian di Polewali Mandar itu ada 6.462 IKM, Pak. Itu industri kecil menengah. dari 6.462 industri kecil menengah itu ada 4.874 IKM non makanan. Artinya di sini ya kayak tenun, furnitur dan lain-lain. Kemudian ada 1.588 industri kecil menengah yang bergerak di bidang pengolahan makanan, Pak. Kemudian di Kabupaten Palembang itu ada 6 komoditi unggulan yang ditetapkan dalam RPIK, Rencana Induk Pengembangan Kawasan Industri Kabupaten. 6 itu yaitu kakao, kopi, kelapa dalam, tenun, terus furnitur, dan satunya saya lupa. Yang saya ingin sampaikan di sini, Pak, kira-kira bentuk kerjasama yang bagaimana yang bisa kami dapatkan, yang bisa kami sampaikan ke Polman untuk meningkatkan kualitas produktivitas dari 6 komoditi yang ada di Kabupaten Palembang, Pak. Saya kira itu saja, Pak. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum. Baik, Pak.
Terima kasih izin Pak Hakim. Saya tertarik juga ini birokrat ini luar biasa Pak Rektor ini bisa menghadirkan birokrat di ruang rektor ya. Ini salut sekali saya ini unsur bar ini pengabdiannya pada masyarakat. Saya kira ini kemitraan yang bagus. Ketika beberapa waktu yang lalu Kepala Kejaksaan Tinggi Sulawesi Barat itu junior saya di Andalas Pak Darmawel. Saya sampaikan saya akan ada kegiatan. Saya perlu ini, dia datangkan produk-produk tenun mandar itu, Pak Rektor, dan kita pajang di sini. Jadi seluruh staf saya pakai perlengkapan itu. Saya juga kontak dengan Pak Bupati, Pak, waktu itu Pak Lukman ya, beliau menggantikan Bupati. Nah, ternyata tesnya sama, Pak Rektor. Orang Thailand Selatan ini suka colorful, Pak. Seperti juga orang Malaysia, warna-warna berani itu. Nah, kalau Malaysia memang ada hubungan historis dengan Bugis ya Pak ya, tapi Thailand Selatan ini juga begitu, mereka suka warna-warna yang berani. Gitu. Dan saya pikir betul perlu kita untuk apa yang dikatakan oleh Chon Tida tadi, rebranding ini penting sekali. Jadi apa, mungkin bantuan dari Pak Rektor ya dengan teman-teman Pak Sebadu membantu kawan-kawan birokrat ini. Jadi kita orang begitu lihat mandar, yang mandar itu nanti kita geser lagi Pak. Jadi mandar itu tidak ada di Makassar sana. Mandar itu ya ada di mandar kan begitu harusnya Pak. Saya surprise Pak, I was shocked Pak ketika saya dibawa oleh Pak Lukman ke tempat tenun mandar itu. Inilah sarung Bugis yang Bapak pakai itu di kampung Bapak, ini pengulu-pengulu pakai ini. Pak tahu saya Pak, di kampung saya disebut sarung Bugis. Sarung Bugis, Pak itu mandar itu adalah suku ya Pak ya. Jadi nah inilah pengetahuan kita. Yang betul sekali, ini bagus sekali nih Pak Rektor. Tadi ada 5 produk ya, Pak Pladinas tadi sebutkan. Kalau bisa disebutkan lagi Pak, apa ya produk-produk apa tadi Pak? Kami agak kurang tercatat.
Ya, jadi Pak Darmawel tadi Pak ya?
Darmawel ya.
Darmawel itu Kajati dulu di sini Pak. Mantan
Kajati betul, ya siap.
Pernah memang di Kedutaan Thailand bertugas.
Ya, dia atas jaksa dulu itu ada kelas saya Pak di Andalas.
Cukup akrab juga dengan beliau itu waktu jadi kajati di sini Pak.
Ya, jadi, betul.
Memang ya, kalau di tenun ini kita khususnya untuk menjadi katakanlah baju itu seperti yang saya pakai ini.
Siap.
Masih cukup lemah di dalam desain.
Siap.
Misalnya
ya. Mic-nya Pak Rektor. Ya.
Jadi perahu itu bisa sampai di Madagaskar itu tadi, Pak.
Iya, ya, sandek ya.
Oh. Ikonnya. Tapi ya. Yang tenun ini hanya bisa membuat di sini juga mengarah ke sana, di sini juga arah ke sana itu. Mestinya yang di sini arah ke sini, yang sini sehingga berhadapan gitu. Kira-kira begitu, Pak. Itu yang belum, desain ini yang belum kita punya. Jadi kalau misalnya nanti Dr. Cumpon ya itu bisa apa namanya membantu masyarakat untuk membuat desain tadi seperti disampaikan oleh pembicara yang terakhir, ya itu saya kira akan menjadi menarik. Banyak hal yang apa, bahkan satu lipatan kain ini seperti batik Jawa itu, kalau penjahit siapapun yang menjahit, semuanya klop. Karena sudah ada khusus depan, di bagian depan kiri dan kanan, di kerahnya, di mindsetnya, di lengan, dan seterusnya. Mungkin ini yang perlu kami, karena kalau ini sudah itu nilainya luar biasa ininya. Ya. Kalau ya, seperti apa terkenalnya sarung mandar itu, karena kalau aslinya itu bisa digenggam begini, Pak, besarnya kan
waktu ya, mandar itu.
Jadi karena sutranya sutra asli, dari kira-kira seperti itu, Pak Konjen.
Betul, Pak. Di Andaman sana ada mitra kita terkenal sekali, dia Torakan, ya, Torakan batik. Dia itu untuk desain bagus sekali. Nanti saya akan konsultasi ke dia bagaimana yang konsen Bapak tadi dalam urusan desain. Tadi baik salah satu pembicara, kalau nggak salah, Cun Tida juga mengatakan tentang desain. Simpel, tapi dia bisa dengan cepat orang paham ini maknanya kemana. Itu barangkali kita harus pikirkan juga, Pak Badu, habis ini untuk manpowering, ya bentuknya FGD barangkali gitu ya, Pak Rektor. Ya. Saya nanti akan keep in touch dengan pihak Bapak untuk menjembatani komunikasi kita dengan masyarakat. Siap, Pak.
Baik, terima kasih, Pak. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih. Pak Kim, silakan, Pak Kim.
Oke, terima kasih, Pak. Mungkin ini sesi terakhir, ya. Before we close the program, maybe I would give for our speakers to give a conclusion for talk today. Maybe I will start from Dr. Nasir, Muhammad Nasir Badu, please welcome. Speaker, Pak.
Buka speaker, Pak Badu. Ininya, Pak, di unmute-kan dulu posisi. Ya, Pak, belum dengar, Pak.
Iya, Pak.
Siap.
Oke, siap. Oke, tentu saja bahwa acara hari ini, saya pakai bahasa Indonesia aja nih atau?
Ya, okay. Sama, Pak.
Oke, okay. Makasih Pak Konsul atas kesempatan, Pak Moderator, thank you very much for giving the second time for this is, I don't want to say that this is the closing statement, but hopefully in the future we can meet again, but maybe we're on a webinar or maybe the other action. So tentu saja kita membutuhkan lebih lanjut daripada kegiatan kita pada hari ini dalam konteks yang lebih implementation. So of course I still need Dr. Professor Tuan Tuan Krucon, we need Dr. Professor Cumpon, and then was that Kontida Ketpet also, because you're expert on packaging, so of course Unsulbar need that, Sulawesi Barat need that, and then we will still on the program that we have a plan together. Jadi insya Allah mudah-mudahan semuanya berjalan lancar. Tentu saya dukungan Pak Konsul juga, Pak, selalu kami perlukan dalam mengimplementasikan program yang kami mau rancang di Unsulbar ini. Karena Pak Rektor alhamdulillah selalu mendukung, Pak, kegiatan-kegiatan seperti ini di kami, sehingga kami bisa eksis untuk selalu bekerja sama dengan siapa saja yang memang membantu kemajuan Unsulbar. Itu saja mungkin penyampaian. Thank you very much, Dr. Abdul Hakim.
Terima kasih, Pak Muhammad Nasir Badu. Silakan Bapak Ahsan Dalaluddin untuk mengasih conclusion. Silakan.
Oke, Pak. Nyala, Pak.
Ya, terima kasih. Jadi yang saya sangat mengapresiasi kegiatan kita ini, Pak Konsul, ya. Mudah-mudahan ini tidak berakhir di sini. Tentu saja kita harapkan mudah-mudahan ini pandemi segera berlalu sehingga teman-teman yang dari Thailand, Pak Dr. Cumpon, ya, Dr. Kontom bisa segera lagi ke Sulawesi Barat, ke Majene, ya, untuk menindaklanjuti, ya. Meskipun tentu juga bisa secara daring, ya, tetapi alangkah baiknya kalau bisa ke sini dengan bahkan Pak Konsul. Dan kami senantiasa menunggu kegiatan lanjutan agar pembicaraan ini tidak sampai di sini. Saya kira itu saja. Terima kasih atas semuanya. Thank you Dr. Cumpon, Dr. Kwantong, thank you everybody. Ya. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima kasih Pak Rektor, Pak Aksan Jalaluddin. Okay, we move now to Assistant Professor Dr. Tuan Tong Kut John. Please welcome to give a conclusion.
Yeah. In the conclusions, I would like to say thank you very much for Pak Rektor and Pak Kongsun that invite us to join in this meeting. I think that in the future, we will have a collaboration together between the government sectors in Indonesia and also the universities. I think Thai University need to promote these concepts in Indonesia, like the concept of universities engagement. It is our concepts in Thailand. And also we need to extend university engagement concept in Indonesia also. And I think that one thing that Indonesia's universities, especially USUBA, must be considered about the linkage inside our campus or inside the universities. Such as my university model, we have the concepts of the community service or community engagement, especially for products development. We need to promote the local product. And after that, we implement the concept of the universities that we build up new faculties, such as we have the new faculties of the faculties of agricultural industry and biotechnology, and matching together with the faculty of fine arts and applied arts to produce the departments of product designs. And also we have the business faculties of economics and business need to promote the marketing part. And also nowadays we need to promote one thing that very popular in the online media, such as a storytelling. The storytelling transform to the customer. It's very nice if we have a good story and amazing story that's produced by the faculties of humanities and social science. This is the linkage inside the university. Maybe the government and also USUBA have to create about the linkage inside the university together, how to build and to work together between the university inside. And after that, we can encourage an engagement with the community with the perfect network. And I think that for universitas in Indonesia, especially Universitas Hasanuddin, Universitas Sulawesi Barat, and also our university, Thaksin University, Metro University, and Suan Usit University will be collaborate together, and we have to work together. Especially, we have to create the research project and the community project together. Especially, we need to develop the people who live in the rural area together. Especially, we are appreciate to help and to develop the field that we expert in Indonesia, and we are ready to visit Indonesia after pandemic COVID pandemic decreed. I promise with you Pak Rector and Pak Consulate, we will visit Indonesia and we have to work together for our citizens, the global citizens, and we are friendly and we are warm welcome also and also exchange knowledge together. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much to Assistant Professor Dr. Chuan Chong Phuc Chong. And please, Assistant Professor Dr. Chumpon Ankananam to give a conclusion. Please welcome. Yang ไม่เปิดไมค์ครับอาจารย
์ Sorry okay thank you for give me a chance to let we know together thank you for the good question that's the problem to me huh? If what the problem about SME or entrepreneur SME right something like that's the model triangle that I would like to show you. That's one. It's Thailand. I think this is the key successful from Thailand. How the Thailand is successful in the entrepreneur or in the small business or medium in business group. You look at what is the main idea. What is the main target? Well-being Indonesia. Also same well-being Thailand. Our is come from what? It come from the strategy of the government. If you would like to do like that, you can ask your province, you are the head of the province, the head of the village or something, someone is that they have the authority, they in charge of the country or they in charge of the area. That's one, they can help you. Why we have like that? Why they have the three point or three triangle? The first one is the country. Everyone know the country is the heart of the people. The center of the people, the country is the everything in the country, included especially in government. We have the leader, we have the government. How make the project community? How help the people successful? Because government, why government have law? Government is a policy maker. Government have the regulation, something like that. Obviously, government have budget, and government can subsidize. Government can support the project, or government encourage some policy. If the people would like to do, they can collaborate. Or government can do by the formal or informal function. If formal, they can come from the government, from the district, or some. If informal, they can ask someone like academic or someone, they push it. That's why the country is very important. The second one is everyone here. Everyone in the class, the university. Why? University have very important for support our project. Because university have knowledge. University have know-how. Why? Because they have a lot of professor Dr. Badu, like the good example. Yeah. And the university have the policy for research and development. If the community, if the people would like to know something, the professor will research and develop it one. Yeah. And the last one, very important. Because university have students. Student is the good one. Student is the hope of the country. That's why university put some knowledge, put some know-how to the student and go back to the village, go back to the community to help the people. That's why. And the last one, very, very important to make our project, to make Indonesia become well-being. That's one, the community. Not successful without community. If the people if the people in the community not agree, not follow the policy, not do that, if the country have some good policy or university try to help, try to put it, but not successful, the community, they have a man or they have the people, and the second one, they have the material or the law material. If 3 points or the 3 person, country, university, and community, they join each other, they collaboration, they work together, I think not too long, Indonesia become the well-being like Thailand. And I promise you, as the Professor Tuan Thong Krut John told, you will never walk alone. We will not leave anyone behind. Thailand, Indonesia, we work together. We learn together. We grow up together because we are friends. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for Assistant Professor Dr. Chumpon Angkananon. Now, please welcome Achan Chontida Kitpet to give a conclusion. Achan Chontida, please welcome.
ที่พูดภาษาไทยนะคะอาจารย
์ได้ครับได้ครับ
ค่ะก็ถ้าในโอกาสต่อไปนะคะถ้าเกิดว่าโครงการครั้งนี้เราได้มีส่วนร่วมมือกันนะคะก็คิดว่าการพัฒนาบรรจุภัณฑ์ของชุมชนหรือว่าท้องถิ่นที่สุราเวสีเนี่ยนะคะก็น่าจะมีการร่วมกันช่วยกันพัฒนาเรื่องของบรรจุภัณฑ์ให้ตรงกับความต้องการของเรื่องของกลุ่มเป้าหมายนะคะแล้วก็โดยใช้ลักษณะของลักษณะเฉพาะของผลิตภัณฑ์ที่มีในท้องถิ่นรวมไปถึงวัสดุที่มีในท้องถิ่นนะคะมาผสมผสานกับความทันสมัยของเรื่องของเทคโนโลยีแล้วก็รูปแบบของบรรจุภัณฑ์นะคะซึ่งจะสามารถคิดว่าจะช่วยส่งเสริมนะคะเรื่องของเศรษฐกิจหรือว่าช่องทางของการตลาดเนี่ยให้กับสินค้าชุมชนได้เป็นอย่างดียิ่งขึ้นนะคะแล้วก็ในโอกาสนี้ก็ขอบคุณท่านกงสุลอินโดนะคะที่ให้การสนับสนุนนะคะแล้วก็ให้โอกาสอันนี้ของพวกเราได้เข้ามานะคะแล้วก็ขอบคุณอาจารย์ทวนทงค่ะในการชวนเข้ามานะคะมีส่วนร่วมในโครงการนี้นะคะก็ขอบคุณเป็นอย่างสูงค่ะขอบคุณค่ะ
ขอบคุณครับยาขอบคุณอาจารย์ชุนดาบิลังขอบคุณBapak Konsul yang sudah dukungprogram ini dan juga terima kasih kepada Bapak Tuan Tong yang invite her to this program dan juga selanjutnya nanti untuk bekerja sama di bidang yang Ibu adakan yaitu cara untuk package terutama di Majene Sulawesi gimana cara untuk bisa mengembangkan cara untuk cara packaging produk sebab untuk mengangkatkan nilai produk di Majene. Salah satunya kita lihat kondisi lokal di sana dan kita bisa guna material di sana juga dan juga cara untuk packaging gimana supaya bisa menjadi bentuk yang modern. Itu keyword yang penting yang kita bisa kerjasama nanti di masa depan. Yeah. Thank you very much for every speaker to give information today. And now, before I turn microphone to the host, Bapak Fajli, I would like to give thanks to everybody to attend to half-day international symposium on the conceptualization of one kampung, one product in Majene, West Sulawesi, Indonesia, perspective sharing between Thailand and Indonesia in collaboration with the consulate of the Republic of Indonesia in Songkhla, Taksim University, Major University, and Universitas Sulawesi Barat. Thank you very much for everyone. And saya juga terima kasih untuk kesempatan sebagai moderator pada hari ini. Mohon maaf kalau jika ada kesalahan dan kesilapan. Dan sekarang, terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Now I turn
my microphone to Bapak Consulate. Terima kasih. Thank you very much.
Terima kasih Pak Abdul Hakim, Dr. Abdul Hakim, ya, beliau ini tamatan IPB, bahasa Indonesianya bagus sekali dan telah membantu kita menerjemahkan ini. Sekali lagi saya menyampaikan apresiasi yang tinggi kepada Bapak Rektor Aksan dari tadi yang telah hadir sampai akhir. Saya tahu di hampir sholat Jumat di sana Pak Nasir Badu yang tetap setia di sini, Pak Dr. Cumpon, Pak Tongtong. Ini ya, kita panggil Dr. Dennis, Pak John Tidak, Ibu John Tidak, dan seluruh partisipan yang hadir yang masih ada di ruangan. Saya mengucapkan ada beberapa, singkat saja, ada kata-kata kunci marketing, ya, marketing berulang-ulang kita sebutkan. Kemudian IT, bahwa kita perlu menggunakan IT. Kemudian ada, ini kalau dalam aspek pendidikan, mohon izin, Profesor Pak Nasir, ini long life education juga, jadi ini adalah peran universitas, perguruan tinggi untuk masyarakat kita. Kemudian adanya pasar turis yang besar di Thailand yang bisa kita manfaatkan sebagai pasar kita terbuka. Jadi tetap ada optimisme untuk kita bangkit dalam UMKM kita dengan packaging yang bagus dan tahan, kita bisa masuk pasar internasional. Sekali lagi, tadi Pak Rektor mengatakan memiliki laboratorium IT yang baik. Pak Nasir Badu, please dapat menggunakan juga medsos kami untuk marketing produk-produk binaan dari Universitas Sulawesi Barat. Please let me know, Pak. Bapak bisa kirimkan ke Agul email atau bagaimana nanti dalam bentuk. Kalau media sosial itu kan singkat, Pak, ya. Ya, umpamanya 1 menit, begitu ya. Sehingga kita bisa publish di media sosial kita, begitu. Sehingga orang bisa tahu Sarung Bugis, Sarung Mandar itu gimana, segala macam, segala macam. Most welcome, Pak. Kami dengan senang hati. Mungkin Bapak ada mau menyampaikan sedikit? Silakan. Ya, mic-nya Pak itu belum di-unmute. Ya, terima kasih ya. Baik, terima kasih Bapak Ibu. Saya ucapkan sekali lagi, thank you very much. Not take you a long time. You can pray Jum'ah in Majene. And I thank you, I appreciate. And in the end of this program, the list of attendance will provide also the certificate of webinar. Ya, will communicate properly with to all of our participants, especially for the community yang diasuh oleh Pak Badu, sehingga mereka punya confidence ya to work together. Menarik tadi, tidak ada yang kita tinggalkan di belakang, don't let one behind, yaitu Thailand punya slogan Pak, credo yang kita juga bisa pakai, don't let one behind. Mari kita bangkit, terima kasih. Semoga Allah SWT meridhoi seluruh ikhtiar kita. Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Kapum makap.
Kapun kap.
Terima kasih. Kapun kap.
Kapun kap.
Kapun kap.
Bye bye.